Hey everybody, my name is Ed. Okay, so we're going to do another trade review. Okay, this is going to be Black Widow from 2001. This trade, this trade collects 2 3-issue miniseries originally published under Marvel's now defunct Marvel's Knights imprint. So it's the Itsy Bitsy Spider, and then the second story is called Breakdown. And the writing is by Devin Grayson with help from Greg Rucka. And the art is by J.G. Jones and Scott Hampton. So Devin Grayson is known probably more for a work from DC Comics. So she's done stuff there like the Titans and Nightwing, I believe. J.G. Jones is most known as a cover artist. And I'd say his work on Mark Millar's Wanted series and Greg Morrison's Marvel Boy. And he also did work for Final Crisis. Greg Rucka, he's done lots of both Marvel DC work and also indie work. Everything from Wonder Woman to Punisher, Stomp Down, Old Guard, etc. Scott Hampton, I don't know as much about. I guess he did some work for Magic the Gathering. He's done stuff on Batman. He's done something called Silver Heels. So, just to give a little history about the character, Black Widow, of course, was created by Stan Lee and artist Don Heck to be an Iron Man antagonist, and she originally teamed up with, like, various Russian henchmen and supervillains. Then she later teamed up with Hawkeye, who also eventually reformed and became a hero, just like Natasha herself. Started out as kind of a Cold War era femme fatale stereotype, kind of morphed into a supervillain with a costume and gadgets, and then transformed again into a good guy. Her first series was a backup feature in Amazing Adventures, and when that comic ended, she became Daredevil's partner and sidekick, and later she kind of drifted in and out of team comics like the Champions and the Avengers. And over the years, she's had like sporadic miniseries and one-shots here and there. Now, Marvel Knights was an interesting imprint. It came out around, or I should say it started around 1998 or so. And basically what it is Marvel farmed out several of their B-level characters to Joe Quesada in Jimmy Palmiotti's Event Comics. So Joe and Jimmy were doing Black Widow, Inhumans, or I should say they were editing. They weren't doing all the creative work, but Daredevil, Black Widow, Inhumans, Black Panther, over there at their studios, they were doing editing and whatnot. And then it was being published by Marvel. It was Marvel did something similar a little bit earlier with their Heroes Reborn. I think the difference between then and I should say this imprint and then the Heroes Reborn thing, so that the Heroes Reborn thing, the characters were kind of taken out of continuity, and they were changed a lot. And then after that contract was over, everything went back to normal. Here, the stories all stayed part of the mainstream continuity. Let's see here. What else can I talk about? Right now the Black Widow movie is out. Now, I've seen it. It's okay, it's just okay. But I am kind of curious as to kind of the rise to some of the characters. So this is Yelena Belova's first appearance, right? And she's played by Florence Pugh in the movie, and pretty much steals the show. But I'm pretty sure, I'm willing to bet that Devin Grayson and J.G. Jones are probably getting a cut. You know, they're probably getting paid for creating the character. Red Guardian seems to be kind of a mashup of a couple of different characters, but they were both created by Roy Thomas. He may or may not be getting paid. If I had to guess, probably just as he's somebody who was with Marvel back in the Stan and Jack days. He was Stan Lee's, you know, kind of right-hand guy, and I'm sure he was able to get some sort of deal going for him. Even if he wasn't able to get a deal then, I think after working in Hollywood off and on for like the last 30, 40 years, you know, he probably knew enough to get a lawyer, you know. Taskmaster is different than his 616 appearances. But again, so I'm not sure how that worked for David Michelinie, who created that character in the Avengers comics. Again, you know, Stan Lee's estate is, there's no question they're getting cut. But I am curious, what about Don Heck? You know what I mean? Don Heck is not known as a, you know, he was just a guy. He was a workhorse. He would just draw whatever they told him to do. He wasn't a guy like Stan Lee or Steve Ditko who would create characters and do the stories and stuff. So I wonder if his estate gets anything. But all right, anyway, getting to the plot of this comic. So the first story is Itsy Bitsy Spider, and it concerns a biotoxin being developed by the fictional country of Rapistan, and both the USA and Russia want the biotoxin. Black Widow gets involved, but so does her Russian replacement, which is Yelena, and then hijinks ensue. The next story is Breakdown, where Natasha and Yelena change faces, and Natasha has to find some nukes in the Hudson River or something to keep them out of the hands of some bad guys. Now, of the two, I actually really prefer the Itsy Bitsy Spider. It's a pretty straightforward action movie espionage story. It's kind of formulaic, but the moral conflict, political crisis, plot twists mostly work. I think there's a few missteps in the pacing, though. And I think it would have been better if the story was told in like 4 issues instead of 3. The structure could have been a little bit better, and the flow would have worked better for me. More details could have been provided. They could have done a little bit more character stuff. And I think there's a few points that seem confused, but if you watch enough action movies, you can kind of, you know, fill in the blanks. I think what pushes this comic in a better than average level is the art of J.G. Jones. The art's very detailed, good anatomy, decent expressions on the face of the characters. If there's a problem, it's that his layouts on a couple of pages is kind of jumbled, you know, it's going for that 90s dazzle. But for the most part, it's really, really good. Now, Breakdown, I had a hard time buying the basic premise. So Natasha changes faces with Yelena in order to teach her some sort of lesson about how you really don't want to, you know, be the type of spy I am or whatever. So they switch identities, and random people try to kill Nat Yelena. And then the real Nat tries to keep, like I said, a random nuke from falling in the hands of this Russian mobster politicians. And it's, I don't know, it feels almost like a bad version of the movie Face Off with John Travolta and Nick Cage, right? Scott Hampton's painted art's not bad, but it is kind of stiff. The layouts are actually a little bit more clear than J.G. Jones's, but his action scenes are kind of, like I said, stiff and awkward. I did like the color tone he used, though. Daredevil guest stars in the story, in both stories, but whatever. I'm pretty sure it's because Black Widow at that same time was guest starring in Kevin Smith and Brian Michael Bendis' Daredevil around that same era. So I do think in both stories, or I do think overall, I'll say it that way, overall, I do actually kind of like the Natasha Yelena dynamic. It's really interesting. It's kind of a play on that old trope of the old gunslinger challenging the young gunslinger challenging the older gunslinger and trying to get a reputation for themselves by taking around the older character. You see that sometimes in Westerns, some action flicks. You know, you get that generational conflict. You get that kind of classic rock versus punk rock thing happening. So just to take a look at some of the art here. Just to look at this, if this works here. This originally was a wraparound cover for the first issue, if you can tell. See? All right. So that's pretty cool. But, all right. So we have some of this going on. You know, nice anatomy, nice figure work happening. Okay. Really detailed art. You know, good in panel composition. Cool action stuff, right? So yeah, J.G. Jones is really on point here. Just really, really nice stuff going on there. And then just to skip ahead here to show you some of the art from Scott Hampton. There's a noticeable change here. Not bad. You know, nice moody color tones. But here everything is simple. It flows nice. But it's all, let's see, here we go. Pretty stiff looking, you know? But that's fine. Okay, so that's it. I don't want to give away the whole thing. But that's it. Pretty, like I said, okay story. Great art from the first story, you know, kind of elevates the whole thing. Okay-ish art, and the second story keeps everything kind of just okay-ish. So that's it. So thank you very much for watching. I do appreciate it. You guys have a good day.